give thanks to Marie and the organizers for sharing this space with us. There's a group of about 20 of us that came up from Toronto as far as Scarborough with clean hearts to show love and to learn from the territory. Myself, I was born in Guatemala, known as the land of the serpent feathered bird, which is a land of the Mayan people. I have been blessed to be on this territory for over 15 years. I've brought over 500 youth of all different nationalities in that time. They have always been received with love and respect and dignity on this territory, and I'm very thankful that we have the opportunity to come back and share our words with you.
We will all be warriors, and that was my dream. African savannas bowing down to the queen. Color of her garb bestowed a magical sheen, anointed with perfume oils, and then she did deem me a warrior. To travel through the times, and every generation you will find my kind. Manifest myself in every womanly mind. I used to gather herbs, formulate the cures for every ailment. People leaving offerings outside my healing tent. My spirit needs to vent for every heaven-sent warrior that I have passed through. During slavery days, I led my people to freedom, freedom, freedom. The Moses of my time, Harriet Tubman, the essence of our bloodline. That's why we all shine, and that's why we remember all the warriors. And if you know a warrior ancestor that you want to shout their name out, we'll do that for like 5 seconds. We remember. We remember. We remember. We remember. Cause see, we've been involved in hundreds of battles. That's why our clothes are torn and still tattered, but my spirit stands firm. Encapsulated in the egg when it's infused with the sperm. Another life to learn, another system to burn. So family with the ferns, cause here we go again, another warrior's turn. Cause here we go again, another warrior's turn. Cause here we go again, it's another warrior's turn. Thank you very much.
Pre-contact. So before contact was made with Indigenous people, what are some things that we might be putting into our baskets?
Ceremony.
Ceremony. I have these cute little flowers here, so we're gonna fill our basket up. Yep.
Harmony.
Pardon?
Harmony.
Harmony.
Medicine.
Medicine. Yeah.
Peace.
Peace.
Language.
Language.
Matriarchs.
Matriarchs.
Rites of passage.
Rites of passage. Power. Power.
Independence.
Independence.
Culture.
Culture. Tradition.
Did people say history?
History.
Family.
Family.
Science.
Science. Anyone else out there? What was that?
Freedom.
Freedom. Art. Art.
Land connection.
Land connection.
Love.
What was that?
Love.
Love.
Dignity.
Dignity.
Connectedness.
Connectedness.
Respect.
Respect.
Virtue.
Virtue.
Identity.
Identity. Put those both in there, so.
Belonging.
Belonging. Yeah. So, if we use our basket metaphor, these are all of the things that pre-contact were being put into our basket. And let's not be totally naive here. You know, there were things that happened in our communities pre-contact. Everything wasn't, these are literally flowers, everything wasn't like flowers and rainbows and sunshine, although it was pretty awesome. Separation of families. So, nobody even said residential schools. So that was a pretty big one too, right? So we're gonna put a couple more in. And then she passes the basket on. Now, what are some, so now she's going through life, and this is her basket. And it does have those flowers in it. It does have those good things in it. But it does have a lot more of those rocks. And so what are some things that she would add to her basket?
Heaviness.
Slavery. Insecurity. She passes it on. So now we have three generations in. Jenica.
Intergenerational trauma.
Yes. Because at this point, now she's carrying everything. And these traumas and the heaviness is compounding that.